It's our next trailer. We are This is our next trailer. We are going to do a trailer reaction for Cobra Kai, Never Die, Season 3.
Season 3, man.
So they're going to drop it in January. I guess the popularity went even higher because they're making them quicker, I think.
Yeah.
Because I think this ain't even been a whole year since Season 2 was out.
Nah, because like last time.
Season 2 was out earlier on YouTube, but it came to Netflix a little later.
So they may, I guess they would have had time to get this out. Yeah.
But, so we I watched the season. Did you watch the rest of that?
Yeah.
Okay, so we watched season 1 and 2. It was good. We did our review. Check us out. I think, we got a review up for that season 2. And I said before, and I said again, they give karate a bad name. Where this is supposed to give karate a good name, but they give karate a bad name. My fault. They give karate a bad name.
Man, like
where they just make it look like. If you know karate, if you got a problem with anybody, you can kick them in the face.
If this had come out when I was a kid, I never would have gotten into a karate class. There was no way I could have sold my mom on karate after this came out.
And nobody, because it just looked like when, if you don't like somebody, because you know karate, if they step on your foot, if they say something rude to you, you can just cross kick their ass in the face.
Even back when I was a kid, one of my homeboys used to call the time of high karate, you know, where everybody was trying to get into a karate class because karate was cool for a hot minute. Yeah,
that was a good hustle from a lot of people.
Oh yeah, yeah.
Just put some pictures of people in karate suits up that said they won tournaments.
How many like master black belt karate guys was there? Like running little dojos and strip malls.
I was one. I went to one of them karate classes.
Yeah. You know,
I forget what belt I got to.
Like, I doubt I made it too far past a yellow belt. But anyways,
yeah.
Like, if this had been out, bro. Like, it took forever to convince my mom I wasn't trying to fight people. I was, but with this out, there would have been no way.
Yeah. Like we said. It had some good stuff. I think the first season was pretty good.
Yeah.
It was good character development, building up Johnny, making Johnny the hero and making Daniel kind of the villain.
And then season 2 came out.
Well, season 2 had some good development, and then they just like fucking, they just said, okay, we're done with the character development. Let's go balls to the wall and just destroy everything we built.
Yeah, pretty much.
Anyway, they had a battle royal at the end that was, I guess they thought it was going to be fun, but it was ridiculous. And somebody actually got hurt. Somebody down there died.
Yeah.
He could have died, but I think he could have got paralyzed or something at the end of the battle royal.
Yeah.
And these are rich valley kids doing this, banging like little thugs. Ridiculous.
Man, like, I can't
even. Even thugs got rules,
look,
right?
Look,
even gangbangers got rules.
I went to a school like that, and I can't imagine anyone scrapping like that. Like, it's so weird to imagine that, dude.
Yeah. So, this is the trailer for season 3, and we're going to check out this trailer, and we're going to have a little reaction for you. So, Cobra Kai season 3 trailer.
I thought I was doing the right thing, but I failed you.
The truth is, you got soft, and we paid the price.
You want Cobra Kai, it's yours.
The whole reason these kids got into trouble was because of us. We can't let them suffer because of our issues. The only way to end this is by working together. So, what do you say?
Your enemies think they're the hero, and you're the villain. There is no good.
Look at this freak.
There is no bad. Only weak,
but strong.
What are you, Tango and Cash?
No, Tango and Cash were narcotics detectives.
Oh, I'm sorry. You do realize neither one of you are cops, right?
I thought we were the good guys.
We try to be. There's one thing I do know for sure. You can't run away from your problems.
I might never be able
to. Go ahead.
Never. Can't. Those are just words. They're meaningless.
You're not
not a kid anymore. The world isn't just gonna hand it to you. You want something, you have to crawl across the floor. Use your damn teeth if you have to. I'm always gonna be right here next to you. Because I'll always be your teacher. Oh, shit. It's all right, you felt like a champ.
Mr. Miyagi taught me everything you knew.
Let us find out.
Cobra Kai season 3. Like that joke, though. He felt like a champ, kid. that looked like it's gonna be good. What'd you think?
They're continuing to embrace chaos. I see that.
But I do kind of like the story of Johnny helping I forget that. Is his name Miguel?
Yeah.
Helping Miguel like walk again. I like that part of the story. But I'm thinking like what's going on with Daniel.
Yeah,
they bring it in. See, that's one thing I was like, it's cool, but I'm like, why they keep bringing in all these people from all these old movies?
Yeah, like I mean, like, and this is the problem.
So
right?
That guy was from part two.
Yeah,
was that he wasn't in a relation to Miss Miyagi? Didn't he? He wanted. Was that Miss Miyagi? That wasn't his daughter, was it?
No.
Was that
no.
Did he have a daughter?
No, no. I don't
was,
think
it
so.
Was like a. Okay, no. It was okay. This was. It was kind of like. It was kind of like on Ninja Turtles where they was rivals.
Yeah.
And his rival had a daughter, but they didn't know if it was Miss Miyagi's daughter or the old dude was taking care of her.
Yeah.
But it was suspected that it was actually Miss Miyagi's daughter.
Right. Right.
I think
right.
That's what it was.
And I think his. Oh, and his either nephew or something was trying to get with her, wasn't it?
Right. That was his rival's nephew.
Yeah.
Okay, but apparently they got married. The fight was meaningless then.
Okay.
I mean, because Daniel went back home, was like, all right, baby, bye. So she was like, oh, yeah, I guess I'll marry you since Daniel left. Which I don't even know if it went like that, but I think it was something like they was fighting over her, though.
Yeah, yeah. But I don't know, man. Like, I don't need them going back into the movies. I don't need it.
Yeah, I mean, I guess it's cameo. It's fun yeah. Little cameo. Because they were talking about bringing back the old boy, Terry Silver.
Look, I don't know if this. We've already done enough to these kids. We don't need them.
Oh, man. They bring him back, boy.
Like, that man was a true psycho.
Yeah. And, but you know something? And he was rich. So he can solve all this stuff. But no. What's his name? The,
might as well be Ted DiBiase.
Right? pretty much. The leader of the dojo now. Teacher. I forget his name. Was it?
Damn,
sensei something, I forget, but he a psycho too.
Yeah.
I'm thinking like where they gonna go with that story I guess they building back now Cobra Kai as officially the bad guys.
Right now I guess they're trying to focus on showing like Johnny and Danny getting together to work things out. And the whole deal with Miguel rather than focusing on the stuff in the dojo, because the stuff we see in the dojo is just what's his name? Kid with the mohawk.
Which I bet you I got the feeling that they're going to have him realize that Cobra Kai is bad and then join Daniel's dojo.
Because all of his character development is basically him realizing that the stuff he was pretending to be was nothing, so he's pretending to be something else.
Who you talking about?
The dude with the mohawk.
Oh, yeah.
went out and got his tattoo.
He was just... And then with that, I forgot what they call that, what you got the thing on your lip. You know what I'm talking about?
Yeah.
It's a, you know, kids have that. Where it happens to kids when they born, and then they end up having that scar.
Yeah. Cleft palate, I think?
Yeah, something like that. And I noticed that, of course, right away, and I was wondering, like, is that a... That's the reason why he kind of like took to karate because he was getting picked on because of that. And that's kind of true. But then he turned into the bully, which is the lesson, I guess. But he didn't really learn his lesson.
No, he didn't. Because
he still was bullying people or whatever, all the people that he was cool with.
His lesson was, man, you out here trying to make us good people? Nah, forget that.
Well, see, and I think real bullies is about to join the Cobra Kai.
Yep.
And then now, and now he's going to turn into, oh, guys, I'm sorry, I was wrong. No, you ain't no bully. You just a wannabe bully.
Yep.
And now some bullies that's really finna come into the school about to start picking on you.
Exactly. Exactly what's about to happen.
Yeah, because that's what it looks like. So, I mean, that's his story. And then he got his daughter, which, you know,
Whatever.
Yeah, I know. That's not too interesting.
It looked like Johnny's kid is in juvie.
Oh, he was?
I think
He probably got in trouble for that whole fight.
Yeah. Looked like he got jumped in.
He was fighting Miguel when he broke his back.
Broke his back.
And I mean, yeah, I guess he would be the one. Yeah. They got to lock somebody up. So that's
right. Cool. I mean, look, somebody got to pay for that.
Right. I mean, you threw the last blow that damn near crippled a kid. You can't just go walk away off that.
And it looked like he going through the same stuff where it's like he thought he was the biggest badass, and then somebody came to remind him he ain't as hard as he thought.
Yeah. So we'll see where they go with that. Like I said, I'm going to watch it. It come out in January, so it's coming out soon. And I'm wondering how they're going to close up this Cobra Kai story. Are we going to do it another tournament, a karate tournament?
I hope not.
You know, I actually hope they will, because I feel like that would tame some of this. Because it's like banging on wax. Keep it in the tournament, y'all.
Yeah.
Stop fighting in the street. Stop fighting like some damn hoodlums and thugs. Because y'all giving martial arts a bad name.
True.
Because if y'all just try to be the, fight in the tournament and be the... Because the first movie had some kind of... Had a little respect to it where he came to... Mr. Miyagi came to the sensei. He's like, look, y'all keep on picking on the dude. I can't be there for him all the time. Back off. And he was like, tell you what. If he beat you out in the tournament, don't ever mess with him again. He's like, bet. Until the tournament, don't nobody touch him. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, now we got some, got some respect there, And now it's just in the show, though, it's fair game. You see somebody out, that's their ass.
Get in them. And that's the thing. Like, that's what makes it feel like thuggish, which is weird considering
very
the
thuggish.
And it's like, if your whole thing is about karate and keeping to the rules and the traditions of karate, it has to stick to either the dojo or the tournament.
Right.
Because the rest of that don't matter.
Right. I mean, and this was like they giving away all the lessons that they try to teach you with karate. You know what I'm saying? All the life lessons and stuff.
Yeah.
All that's out the window. All about kicking and punching now.
Yeah, they trashed all that.
And that's sad because that's what it was all about. You know what I'm saying? Where it's got fighting in there, but it was to teach you how to be better yourself. How to, you know what I'm saying? How to beat the odds. Not how to just whoop somebody ass. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, I really didn't like where they went, but it still was entertaining. And I believe that this season's going to be entertaining, so I can't wait to see it. What are we looking at? That's our reaction for Cobra Kai season 2.
Three.
Cobra Kai season 3.